Well, Matt, one win was all the Lloydminster Twins needed to capture yet another NSRBL title.
Yeah, got it right on the nose with that one. They were in Meadow Lake last night for game two. And for the first time in the team's history, the Twins are champions for the fourth year in a row as they sweep the Sox 7-5. The Twins had an unbelievable postseason, going 6-1, outscoring the opposition 58-18 in those seven games. So a dominating performance from the Twins. The Lloydminster Betcave Rebels got off to a slow start at the Under-16 Girls Fast Pitch Canadian Championship in Brantford, Ontario, dropping their first two games, but today the girls had a chance to get back to 500 with a pair of games against BC teams. It was a heartbreaker this morning as the White Rock Renegades would score the only run of the game in the bottom of the seventh, handing the Rebels their third loss in a row. And it didn't get any easier this afternoon, once again getting shut out by the Delta Heat 5-0. The Rebels will finish the round robin tomorrow with a pair of games. He's a seven-time Stanley Cup champion. He's a first ballot Hall of Famer, and he's in Frog Lake. Emma Murphy has more on the first annual Brian Trottier Hockey Camp.
Last September, Frog Lake was generous enough to invite me over for the grand opening. And it's a great facility here. And I think through some real good leadership, they wanted to do something for the kids in the summertime. And they asked if I'd come back and do a little hockey camp, and I told them I'd be happy to.
It's only the second year the arena has been up and running, but it's already pulling the community together and creating some strong interest from hockey's biggest stars.
3 years ago, the youth came and sat in front of their leadership and asked for a hockey arena. So we're really trying to make use of it every hour of the day. So
we'll have three more weeks here with Gaston Gingras coming in and Gino Ogic and Reggie Leach. So we've got a good crew of former NHLers instructing the kids and being the head coach.
With the help of local hockey stars, Trottier is teaching kids how to play and love the game.
I like playing hockey like against each other.
They want to participate. They want to improve their skills. They want to be able to be competitive at all the tournaments. And that's what we want to do to motivate them, so that when they get out on the ice, they feel really confident about themselves. They feel like, man, I've really improved.
72 kids are enrolled for this week, getting on ice and dry land training every day.
I just want them to have a really good time, and I want them to feel like this is a very safe place for them to come, where they can just have fun and, you know, make new friends and bond and, yeah, just share this whole journey with their family.
Trottier hopes to return annually for the camp. There are still spots available for the remaining 3 weeks of this year's school. Emmett Murphy, Newcap Sports.
As I mentioned earlier in the cast, the Betcave Rebels have got off to a slow start at the Canadian Championships. But on this week's Superstar Next Door, I show you a girl who's had a huge part to the team's success on their road to the Canadians.
Kaylee Butts got into softball at a young age, making lots of friends when she first started. She has taken her career to the next level.
I like the intensity. Like, you have to be in it or else you'll mess up. And it's a great feeling when you do something good, and when you mess up, it makes you want to try harder.
She's pretty calm and cool. She's easygoing. She doesn't get rattled too often, and, you know, she just does things naturally. It just comes natural to her, so.
Taking on huge roles, hitting cleanup, and playing at the shortstop position, Kaylee has developed into one of the team's leaders on and off the field.
It's good when, like, it feels good when people ask for help, because then, I don't know, you're not just sitting there. Like, you feel like you're part of the team.
Not old enough to drive, Kaylee has set some big goals for herself.
I'd like to try for a scholarship for school. Team Canada would be sweet, but I don't know. Just go far in it and try for a scholarship.